Hey, brothers and sisters, I'm back. Praise God, brothers and sisters. The Lord has, what are you going to do? The Lord has just filled me with His joy, you know? It's just revival. Tonight, earlier today, the Lord began to give me a deeper understanding. As a matter of fact, when I woke up, the Lord was giving me a deeper understanding of the vision that I posted yesterday about the rapture. And then again tonight, the Lord showed me a whole nother level. You know, so I want to talk about those levels, brothers and sisters. The things that the Lord showed me. You go watch the video, but I'll just go through it quickly. In my vision, brothers and sisters, I was there in heaven, and the Lord was in the midst of the throne, the Lord Jesus Christ. He had on a crown and a great white flowing robe, and He had the scroll in His hand, which is the scroll from Revelation chapter 6, along in there where with the seals on it. He took that scroll, and I was... like where I'm at right now, the Lord was in the midst of the throne. To this side, to my left, was a woman who is the bride. And then straight ahead of me was the earth. And then, you know, I couldn't see what was to, you know, it was behind the throne, was to the right of me. And so, as I was standing there, the Lord took that scroll and He touched me on top of the head with a scroll. Now the Lord gave me a second level interpretation of this vision. When the Lord touched me with a scroll, it was revival for the church. And then when the Lord touched the woman, a golden river came out of living water, of living gold, came out of the scroll and covered the woman, and she was consumed with it. She was baptized in it, and she was gone. As I said yesterday, I was talking about the rapture, revival and the rapture. Then the third thing the Lord did was turn toward the earth, and that was the end of the vision. But the second layer, I've got two more layers, and then the Lord wants to show me more layers. As a matter of fact, I was going to wait to make this video, but I want to get these two out, because it's getting too... The Lord has been showing me all these layers and dualities and all these things. Those of you who have watched my videos about dualities and stuff, it's awesome. The Lord is just dumping all this new stuff on me. Okay, here's the second layer. When the Lord touched me with the scroll, that I was representing the church age revival. Being prepared to be a bride without spot or blemish. When the Lord touched the bride and the gold came down, that was the rapture. And what the Lord was telling me, it's just like, and I'm going to touch on a little bit about the enemy side as I'm doing this, because I can't really, you need to hear this. Okay, the ancient name for Egypt is alchemy. So alchemy, okay? Those of you who've been watching my videos, you know the things I'm talking about. Well, the ancient thing, like with Rumpelstiltskin, okay, the book, demonic Rumpelstiltskin, the old belief or saying of these alchemists was to turn lead into gold. And I've made videos in the past how, to the uninitiated, that's what they would say. And then there's even more layers beyond what I'm saying. There's degrees in masonry. There's degrees and degrees and degrees. There's layers and layers and layers of evil. And then with God, there's layers and layers. You know, it's like an onion. Of course, you go on and on and on, you know, and higher levels of understanding in God, and also, of course, the perversion of that, what the enemy's trying to do, okay? So I'm just touching on just the tip of this. You know, there's, for those of you who think in scientifically, in science fictionally, you know, there's many dimensions, infinite dimensions to God. So we're talking about just a few dimensions beyond the third one that we live in, or the fourth dimension that we live in, space and time continuum. to quote from Back to the Future, right? Anyway, so the bride turned, you know, that gold covered, she turned to gold. The gold represents eternal, you know, taking off the jars of clay. You know, just we've been listening, you know, I just played that song from Third Day on the last video, yesterday. And then there's another famous pop Christian group called Jars of Clay. Well, the Bible, you know, talks about we are jars of clay. We are earthen vessels, which we literally are. The name Adam means red earth man. You know, and then the scientists 100 years ago, just like they did about lots of things, they mocked the Bible. Oh, people are not made out of dirt. You know, before they had microscopes and knew about DNA and all that, and all the compounds and atoms and all that. You know, these, you know, goofy atheists like Humes and all these other atheists back in the day, oh, the Bible's so dumb, saying we're made out of dirt. We're not made out of dirt. But in reality, now that science has caught up with the Bible, they found, oh yeah, well, it's true. You know, the same elements is used to make man. So that's why Adam was made from the dust of the earth. That's why we are earthen vessels, as Paul said. We're jars of clay. And when we get raptured, And like in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 51 and 52, you know, it says, we will not all sleep, but we'll be changed in a moment in the twinkling of an eye. You know, we'll take off this corruptible body, this earthen vessel, and put on incorruption. Well, you know, incorruption, incorruptible, is represented at this space-time continuum in the third dimension. You know, we're living in the third dimension, but within the fourth dimension, space and time. Okay, here we are in this dimension. And so gold is a representation of durability and eternal life and all that. What God would display to us and use that we can understand is gold. So gold is symbolic with immortality, with godhood, with eternal life. Now, brothers and sisters, of course, we won't be God. But of course, we will have our glorified bodies. As John said, we will be like him when we see him. He's talking about the rapture. He says we will be like him. We will be like him. So we will have our glorified bodies, as Paul's talking about. We will not all sleep. We will change in a moment of twinkling of an eye. We'll put off this corruptible earthen vessel and put on, you know, our incorruptible body, represented by gold. So at the next level, and there's many more levels, brothers and sisters, and God is showing me more and more levels, and I'm going to go through another level, talk about space and time. The Lord gave me a dimension about this, about time, and I don't even understand what it means, but I'm going to put it out there. You guys are going to, those of you who are on the deep end of the pool, you're going to love it, because it's beyond what I know, but I know the Lord will give me the interpretation. Later on, we'll get the interpretation. So that was the rapture, putting on the incorruptible. The bride put on the incorruptible, which is represented by gold. She was baptized in it, and she disappeared. She walked with God, and then she was no more. So me, I was representing the church age, which has been the same since the time of the apostles. That was the rapture, and straight on the other side was the earth. Now what that represented, besides the judgments of God, as God would open, the Lord Jesus Christ would open the seals, it also represents Israel, brothers and sisters, Israel. And I'll tell you why. And I want to go back to that next level. Let me finish this layer. I mean, God give me the grace and wisdom to even say this and explain it. Israel is the natural seed of Abraham. Those of you watching my videos, you can understand what I'm saying. And I pray God to give you the wisdom. Israel is the natural seed of Abraham. It's represented with the earth. God's time clock on earth is the literal physical nation of Israel. What God does. We can look to Israel to see what God's doing as far as the end times. It's one of the clocks, and a major clock that God uses to restart the clock that he turned off. The 70 weeks of Daniel, the 69th week was cut off the day the Lord went in and he was received as the Messiah. We call it Palm Sunday, when the Lord rode in on the ass of a colt, the fold of an ass. You know, and I just wanted to have an excuse to say the word ass in the video, so that's why I said it. No, just teasing, it's a jackass, you know. So he rode in on the colt of an ass on Palm Sunday, brothers and sisters, and that cut off the 69th week of Daniel. And then the clock stopped. When he walked in there, they received him. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna to the Son of David. Hosanna is victory. As a matter of fact, they were using, it wasn't a Hebrew word. As a matter of fact, it's a Greek word. Victory to the Son of David. And all those things they were saying and calling out, he was received as a Messiah that day by the people, but rejected by the leaders and rejected by, finally, by everybody, because it got the people stirred up that, we only follow Caesar, you know, and all that. They had the Lord killed, as the Bible said he would, and the Lord fulfilled all things that the Lord sent him to do, and that was supposed to happen. But then that 70th week kicks off again. That's the tribulation period, but the cycles of the Shemitah and the cycles of the Jubilee leading to that, 1948, Israel became a nation, May 14th, in the Gregorian calendar. May 14th, 1948, they became a nation. Then, you know, the Six-Day War, the first week of June, I believe it's about June the 6th or June the 7th, 1967, they recaptured Jerusalem. And I talked about this in the video of the day. It's the, you know, there's the, it ended the season of the desolation of the land, of the nation of Israel. Then it ended the desolation of the city of Jerusalem. Two different desolations, each a 70-year period into the time of Daniel. Now, the Lord had given me that information. I meant to make a video about it, but I didn't get my mind fully wrapped around it to explain it completely. But there's two different desolations. As the people returned partially, and then they rebuilt the temple. As two different times of desolation that God put on them. Two different judgments, both of 70 years. I don't want to get into all that. I just touched on it. Some of you probably know about it. Remind me about it. Let's run with it next time. Anyway, so the earth that was on the other side, it represents, and the lowest level, it represents that God's about to open the seals and all hell's about to break loose on earth. But it, secondly, it represents the natural seed of Abraham, which is the Adam, the sons of Adam and the sons of Abraham. You're talking about the flesh and blood, earthen vessel sons of God under the sons of Abraham, Isaac and Jacob. You're talking about the nation of Israel. That's what they represent, that red earth man. You know, the dirt, natural. Then we, the church, are the spiritual manifestation, the spiritual covenant that God made. You know, this by grace through faith, not by the deeds of the law. That's the difference. Okay? And so, when the fourth thing, that behind the Lord is telling me, that's when he reconciles all things unto himself. We become one new man. The Lord reconciles all things unto himself. The Bible says at the end, the Lord would reconcile all things to himself, and then he would reconcile it to the Father. You know? So, it's, and I forgot where it is in the Bible. I haven't read it in a while, but the Lord gave me this afternoon. So he reconciles everything to himself, and then he might present it to the Father, the Bible says. See if I can. You can Google it and look it up. It's there in the Apostle Paul talked about it. And anyway, if I have time, I'll find it and I'll put it on here as a little caption. Anyway, brothers and sisters, so that's the second layer. Now the third layer, and there's many more. The third level of understanding this that the Lord showed me is that where I was standing, I never would have never thought about this in a million years, and I really still don't know what it means. You guys can help me. Where I was standing at is the first watch. The Lord revived us in the first watch. Okay, the first watch is like 9 o'clock, between 6 and 9 o'clock in the evening in the Bible, okay? Then the second watch goes, you know, whatever, from 9 or 10, whatever it is, to midnight. At the midnight hour, the cry rang out, "Behold, the bridegroom cometh." So the second watch ends at the midnight hour. That's the rapture of the church at the midnight hour. Now, this is deep stuff. This is what the Lord gave me. I would have never heard this. I've never thought about it. It's never even been in anywhere in the league of what I, something that I would think of. But this is from the Lord. And I know some of you can understand it better than me and pray about it. I know the Lord will give me a more complete interpretation. And some of you guys can help me. I know. So at the midnight hours, the second watch of the night, the bride is taken. She is no more. She's walked with Christ and she's no more. She had oil in her lamp and she's gone. Then the third watch, the Lord turned from the first watch and he revived me. At the second watch, he took me. He took the bride, us. The bride was taken. The third watch, he put on his judgments on the earth and on the nation of Israel and dealt with them. Then the fourth watch, he reconciled all things unto himself, that he might reconcile and present all things to the Father reconciled. Now that's the message that the Lord gave me this afternoon. Now that's way out there, brothers and sisters. But it's from the living God, and I praise God for it because, of course, it's biblical and it makes sense. And it's so far beyond anything I'd ever thought of. I don't even understand what it means, really, fully. But I'll pray about it, and I ask you guys to pray about it. So praise God for that, brothers and sisters. It's really cool and really awesome. And then there's more layers. The Lord is trying to show me more layers, but I stopped because I wanted to get this part out, and then I'll come back and line upon line on it some more later on. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you. May the Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face to shine upon you. Hallelujah. Praise his blessed name, brothers and sisters, for the Lord is good. He's awesome. He's coming for us. That's the main thing. And you know, for this deep end of the stuff, you know, we don't have to know it to go in the rapture. But there's things here that the Lord wants us to know. Those of us, you know, who are interested in those things, God wants us to know them and understand them and thank God for his wisdom. Bless his holy name. But you don't have to know any of these things. You know, the Bible, Jesus said you must become like a little child to enter the kingdom of heaven. So praise God. Praise God. You know, we have to be childlike in our faith and trust of the Lord. And then beyond that, you know, we can get into these deeper things that the Lord will lead us in different areas. You know, I believe that every ministry has got a calling in a different area, and then people of like-mindedness are attracted to that. That's how it works. So praise God. You know, praise God. Praise God for that. Bless his name. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you. And I wanted to say, give an example, make a joke about somebody, some other YouTubers, that if, you know, if you're a follower of them, well, you know, they're crazy, so that must mean you're crazy too, right? But I didn't want to get into it too much, but I couldn't help myself. If I hadn't have said it, maybe I'd have got sick. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you. Have a blessed day. By the grace of God, maybe I'll make more videos as the Lord leads me. Who knows? God bless.